This movie will review how to generate a movie using the Volume Render Sequence tool. Select your data set and then open up the Volume Render module. In the Volume Render module, open up the Preview window and then the Sequence tool. By default, a Z-Rotation action is already available in the Sequence tool. Click on the Modify button and then click on the Z-Rotation action. Change the name to Threshold and set the number of frames from 15 to 32. 16 frames are needed to generate 1 second of movie. Let's update this movie from a rotation to a threshold. Select the threshold parameter from the drop-down menu. Set the end minimum threshold to 145. This provides a threshold level that will show us the bone. Because we will add additional actions after this action, check the persistent option. To preview the movie so far, click on Sequence, and then Make Sequence, and then check on the Preview Sequence option. To add an action, click on the Add Action button, and then click on the Sequence tool. Click Modify, and then click on the New Action. Next, we'll add a rotation action. Rename the action name to Rotation, and then set the number of frames to 32. Set the parameter from Threshold to Rotation. The default parameters here will provide us with a Z rotation of 360 degrees. To review the movie, select Sequence, Make Sequence, and then click on the Preview the Sequence. To save this movie out to the Analyze workspace, select File, Save Renderings, and check the Save After Each Render option. Name your movie, and then click on the Make Sequence button. Click on Make the Sequence. The sequence will be made and automatically saved to the Analyze workspace. Here, the movie can be previewed in the Movie tool. To save the movie out of Analyze, select File and then Save. The movie can be saved in the QuickTime or AVI file formats. For more information about Analyze, please be sure to check out our other help movies.